Some daily bubble walks just don't cut it. So welcome news that gyms are back in business under level two. With a few tweaks, it won't quite look like this.
It's been tough. We're ready to get back. We need to get back up and running as best we can.
It's been a hard 7-week slog, but now...
We are ready to move into level two, to open up the economy, but to do it as safely as possible.
Come Thursday, it'll mean heading back to the office. You'll be able to sit inside a cafe rather than queue for your brew. Real-life retail therapy is back. Bubbles won't be a thing anymore, and schools will be back on Monday.
I think it's good for people's mental health. I think a lot of people are feeling pretty trapped and isolated.
The waiter's still out there, so we got to be careful.
I was just texting a bar I know to book a table for six, so that's going to be a highlight.
Just seeing people again will be really nice.
A trip to the movies is back on, and getting that shaggy mane sorted will be welcome news for many.
Definitely due for a cut and a bit of a colour.
My partner cut my hair already, and she can cut it again for me now.
And we'll be able to visit friends and family again within New Zealand.
Go and see your mum. Just don't turn it into a massive family reunion while you're at it.
It's really good news. New Zealand, I think, is ready to get back into a form of normality. And, you know, I think from government to opposition, Parliament's attention now really has to turn to how we can save jobs.
But it's not a complete free-for-all. You can't have a gathering of more than 10 people, and that includes weddings and funerals.
Why 10? Simple. If something goes wrong with a group of 10, that is much easier to contain, much easier to contact trace.
It will be harder to police in people's homes. There have been 1,108 breaches and 265 prosecutions since Level 3 began 2 weeks ago. To make this call, officials weighed up things like low case numbers, the fact that our contact tracing is better, and that we can now test up to 12,500 people a day. But it's a big shift.
I understand why people are nervous.
But the message is, it's worked.
You created a wall that meant the virus couldn't reach those that it could easily take. And for that, there are many people who are grateful to you, their team of 5 million.
Many in that team now eager to get back to business.
And Jess is with us now live. Another restriction, Jess, a time limit if you want to go to a restaurant or bar.
So if you want to go to a bar or a restaurant, you can only stay for 2 hours. That's the time limit. So tables of up to 10 people will be spaced around the room, but you won't be able to stay there all night. But that won't apply if you have people round for dinner to your house, for example. They can stay a bit longer or as long as you like, really. In terms of that 10-person limit, that's going to be reviewed in 2 weeks' time, and all going well, that number will go up after that.
What about masks, Jess? So much talk about masks. Should we or shouldn't we? Any official details today?
Well, some countries around the world are making it mandatory for people to wear masks in public, and there are lots of images that are coming in from around the world showing people wearing masks going to the supermarket, for example. But the ruling from the government is that it's just not necessary here in New Zealand. There are concerns that people need to be trained properly to be able to use them. The Prime Minister saying, for example, that surgical masks need to be replaced 3 times an hour. So the ruling is that it's just not worth it here in New Zealand right now.